Well, it would have been the hardest scene had I known more than 2 minutes before we shot it that we were going to do it in one take, or before I got there that it was going to be the very first day of shooting at 3 a.m. It was kind of 3 a.m. It was like, oh, I'm going to do this scene now and we're doing it in one take, which for an actor is normally you'd be told in advance, but then it's great. It's great not to have time to worry, so we just did it. I mean, you're right. The way it was written, I guess we all harbour resentments and feelings for our parents that we probably mostly end up not telling them. The great thing about my job is fiction. You can get to say all the unsayable things in films and plays that in real life you really shouldn't do, because, I mean, you can think whatever you like in real life, but it's best not to say everything you're thinking. It's something I've learned. By our great, I think, love of Paolo's work. I mean, really, a love of his work, a love of his vision and point of view, and his poetry, and his humanity, and his lack of judgment, and his spirit, and his soul. He's so soulful. His films are so full of soul. And they examine really the big questions about why we're here and what's my life, you know, in such a poetic, rich, funny, delicious way. So yeah, I mean, to work with Jane Fonda and Harvey Keitel and Michael Caine, they're legends. I was working with legends who were playing legends. I think Paolo was getting them to play with their own iconography in a way within the film. In the film tries to hold on to it through too long, not through plastic surgery but through her spirit. So in her spirit she doesn't grow up, she stays her daddy's little girl, and she needs to move on. She's held on to her youth for too long. I mean, this movie really isn't about the vanity and the physicality of aging. It's not really about that kind of youth. I think it's about this, the spirit of youth in our hearts and our souls. It's about what youth really is, because youth is